I'm Carter Lindenfield.
And I'm John Bradford. And this is our documentary on the environmental effects of plastic water bottles on the environment.
And other alternatives you can use that are environmentally friendly. Enjoy. Bottled water is now the second largest selling non-alcoholic beverage in Canada. Behind pop, that is.
80 million plastic bottles are disposed of per day in North America. That works out to about 29 billion bottles per year.
In 2007, more than 17 million barrels of oil were used to produce plastic water bottles in the U.S. That's the equivalent of fueling more than 1 million cars for a year.
The UN estimates that it would cost about $30 billion to provide everyone in the world with clean drinking water.
But if you think that's a lot of money.
But last year, $100 billion was spent on bottled water worldwide.
People in Canada pay from $1 to $4 a gallon for bottled water for the perception that just bottled water is cleaner than tap water. But actually, over 90% of the cost of bottled water goes to the bottle, the lid, and the label.
So we're here at the City of London's landfill site, and we're going to go check it out. 4 out of every 5 plastic water bottles end up in landfills, just like that one. Water bottles in landfills can take up to 1,000 years to biodegrade. Plastic water bottles that are buried in landfills just like these can leak many toxic chemicals into our environment.
Okay, now you can clearly see the effect that plastic water bottles have on the environment. But we did a taste test to see if there really is any difference between water bottles and the more environmentally friendly tap water.
So this is taste test number 1 with Rick Lindenfield. The glass on your left is Dasani bottled water made by Coca-Cola. The glass in the middle is Rio Canadian Natural Springs bottled water. And the glass on your right is City of London's tap water.
Not really. Not bad.
Dun, dun, dun.
So what were your overall impressions on the types of water?
The Sandy, I didn't like it at all. As soon as I tasted it, even though it was cold. This wasn't too bad. The Rio Canadian Natural Spring. But I thought the tap water tasted the best, the purest of them all.
After seeing some alarming things inside A.B. Lucas Secondary School, we decided to interview Peggy Sattler, our school board trustee, to get her take on bottled water inside Thames Valley Schools. Peggy Sattler was re-elected as chair of the Thames Valley District School Board in November 2007 for a second consecutive term. Peggy serves on several board committees, including the Environmental Advisory Committee, and she is the director of the Ontario Public School Boards Association.
What first got you interested in bottled water?
Well, I've always considered myself an environmentalist, and then we had some students from Central Secondary School came to the school board and did a presentation about why they believed that the board should get rid of bottled water in our schools. And then our board's vending machine truck was coming up for renewal, so we had to look at what kinds of products we wanted to sell in the vending machines.
and I thought it would be a good idea to bring forward a motion at the time to consider the phase out of bottled water sales in our schools.
Why do you believe that bottled water should not be sold in schools?
Well, really there's four main reasons. The first is the environmental impact. In terms of the 3R hierarchy.
I'm not afraid to take a stand. Everybody, come take my hand, come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm, whatever weather, cold or warm.
Reduce the amount of waste that's going to the landfill. And we can do that by reusing and recycling. So if we have refillable bottled waters, then we're not producing waste that's going to the landfill.
The government here in London, Ontario, has voted to stop selling bottled water in all municipal buildings. The vote was 15-3, so there was little opposition to the motion. The ban will extend to City Hall, city-owned buildings, hockey arenas, community centers. Now the city will have to ensure that fountains are installed everywhere that water is prohibited, so people can still get a drink. London sets a good precedent, and other Canadian cities are following suit, like Toronto, Windsor, Vancouver, Montreal, Saskatoon.
Over the past 10 years, the Pacific Ocean has been filling up with plastic, and now covers up to 2.5 million miles. That's equivalent to the size of Australia!
What has the Thames Valley District School Board done to combat bottled water in schools?
Well, I introduced a motion to eliminate the phase-out, or to start the phase-out of bottled water from vending machines, and the trustees at the time decided that we needed to have a public input meeting to get some...
I think that there's ways that you can get around that. You know, the schools could sell refillable bottled water as or refillable water bottles as fundraisers, and there's other things that can be done.
We will hope to be doing more to educate students about the environmental impact of bottled water and to encourage school communities that want to do something about the sale of bottled water to try to minimize the use of bottled water.
We're here at Hockey Night in Canada's play-on 4-on-4 hockey tournament, and it's good to see that they're handing out reusable water bottles instead of plastic water bottles, so it's very environmentally friendly here. So as you guys can see, bottled water isn't just bad for you guys, it's also extremely bad for the environment.
There are many alternatives to bottled water, like water fountains. And refillable water bottles. Whew, refreshing.
We hope you enjoyed our documentary on the effects of bottled water on the environment.
We really hope this informed you about the consequences of drinking bottled water.
And remember, next time you reach for a bottle of water,
reach for the tap.
I'm not afraid to take a stand. Everybody, come take my hand. Today, I'm breaking down.